to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Visuals with Nags series where I'm going to discuss about Gantt chart. Let us try to discuss what it is and when to use this in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So Gantt chart is basically a type of bar chart and that illustrates a project schedule. As you can see, like, the tasks to be performed will be available in the vertical axis. What are the tasks or the projects you need to track will be available in your vertical axis, and the time intervals on the horizontal axis. You can see time interval, instead of having it in the x-axis at the bottom, the time interval will be appearing at the top, right? But it is not exactly the bar chart, but it looks like differently to track the project. So this project has to be started here and to be ended here, and what is the current status of it. That is what you can easily track each project, or in the project each stages how it is performing. With this note, let us try to demonstrate in Power BI. We are in Power BI now. And as usual, this is not available in the default visualization, the Gantt chart. So in order to do that, we need to import it, right? So go to Get More Visuals. You go to the App Source and start typing Gantt chart. Hit Enter and you can see it here. There are different options, and I want to highlight, like, for each and a different visuals available here, you need to compute the data that matches this chart. Basically, for each chart, there should be some data format. The data should be in this format, right? Either the start date, end date should be in a column, or for each stages it should be in the column, right? Let me show it to you what I'm trying to say. Let us try to import it. Click on add. You can go for any Gantt chart, but for understanding the Gantt chart, I'm trying to explain with the basic chart. So what I'm trying to say here, so this is the Gantt chart once we have imported. Now let us go and check the data here, where I have two projects, that is 05 and 06, where each stage, kickoff, execution, UAT, go live, these are the different stages in each of the project. So there is a planned date for it and actual date for it, right? And there is some times for each stage, you have some milestones as well. So for this Gantt chart to work, you need to have a data like this. If you're in your source, you do not have a data in this format. Instead of this, the kickoff, execution, UAT, go live, everything will be available in a column, like kickoff, start date, completion date in a column, maintenance, start date, maintenance, completion will be the column. So basically for each project, you have a single record and different columns. Then you need to convert into this way, then only this Gantt chart will work. That is what I meant for other visuals. Other Gantt charts require different format of data, the data structure. So you need to ensure that is done. So for now, to demonstrate this Gantt chart, the simple Gantt chart, let us begin with our data set, whatever we exist. So when I click on it, it will appear here. Then let me explain the mandatory fields here. As we are going to track the project schedule, any schedule should have a start date and end date. So let us try to drag and drop the start date and end date first. And this is the start date and this is the end date. So I have put it here. Then another important field here is the task, that is whatever you want to track. Let us start with the project. It is combined for each record, for each row, whatever you have for each row in the table. But that is not our intended behavior. Our intended data should see the, for each project, you need to single only once this project. So in order to do that, drag and drop the legend, right? Or, I mean, first, in order to see it in a single way, group task. When you enable it, see, you can see many unique you have, you will have those tasks. Now for each task, what are these start date ended for different stages, right? In order to view that, you go and check the stages. In legends, you put the stages. Now you can clearly see here for each project, you have a start date, that is, it is from January the 1st and 2020, right? And end date is 15th of January 2020. So this is what you can able to see it here. That is the thing, right? And you also noted like here it is comes as earliest. This is not the correct one because we have two dates for completion date. That is for, if you consider what I'm trying to say is for each stage, right? For 05 05, and we are seeing the kick, you click on kickoff, or another one is for actual. So there are two start dates and two completion date. This can be different dates, right? So but now how you are seeing it here, here you can see it is comes as a earliest date, right? So if you want to track the project without actual, only the actual, then this view, whatever you are viewing, is perfectly all right, right? What is the current state of each project? And in order to view it by split, like for this project, what is my actual and planned, then you need to use this project in the parent, then your task should be planned or actual. There you go. Now you can see for this project 05, you have planned start date is from January the 1st and end date is 31st of January, and your kickoff date for actual is ended on January the 15th. From this view, you can quickly see this kickoff is what the actual is completed earlier to that, right? So this is what you can easily track your projects based on the planned and actual activities for this Gantt chart. I hope we have seen how you can configure. Let me quickly explain some of the key of it. In order to change it to yearly or this period, this is the property, the date type. You can see like a month, or better, you can keep it as year, right? So for each year, you can keep, this is the whole data, the from 2023 years. So you can see different stages here. This is the first property. Then I have to expand this one. The another property is like I think it will be like a category. Increase this width. So let me increase it to 150. Can view, so you can view this one. So these are the two important properties you can think of. There are other properties that I have already explained. You need to group the task, and you can have milestones here. I mean to say, like milestones, right? Here you can add the milestone. So milestones, once you have it, you can have some values over here. These are the different milestones you can set off. Now, one more thing I want to highlight here is this is the today, right? This is the indicator of whenever you are having the bar here. This is indicates like this is today's date. You can enable or disable this. Then instead of the end date, right here, you can have the duration field. You do not have the end date, but you have a duration, start date and duration. Okay, you can have that column here. Then in the properties, you have something called duration, right? You can see here number of duration unit, whether you are mentioning it in number of days or duration in weeks or hours. Okay, there might be sometimes it will be you are tracking every day, so duration can be hours or minutes, so you need to mention that here. You can change that property as well. So this is what a Gantt chart. Using this Gantt chart, you can easily track your projects and what are the different properties available. I've explained it. I hope you like this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.